हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी चैप्टर नंबर 11 केमिस्ट्री ऑफ नॉन मेटल्स क्लास 10th साइंस. सो दिस इज़ द सिनॉप्सिस. दैट मीन्स व्हाट आर द टॉपिक्स वी आर गोइंग टू कवर. सो फर्स्ट वन विल बी इंट्रोडक्शन, फिजिकल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ नॉन मेटल, पोजिशन ऑफ नॉन मेटल इन द पीरियोडिक टेबल, डिस्कवरी ऑफ नॉन मेटल्स एंड फाइनली केमिकल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ द नॉन मेटल्स. सो विदाउट वेस्टिंग टाइम लेट अस स्टार्ट इंट्रोडक्शन. Non-metals are the element that do not conduct electricity and are neither malleable nor ductile. For example, carbon, sulfur, phosphorus, silicon, hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, chlorine, bromine, neon, argon, etc. So, in the chapter of the periodic table, we studied about the elements. जैसा कि periodic table chapter already आप लोगों का cover हो चुका है. So, what we have seen that maximum elements are metals. आप देखोगे तो maximum number of elements उसमें metals ही हैं. Only there are some non-metals which are located in the P block. That means group number 13, 14, 15, 16, 17 and 18. अगर आप periodic table देखेंगे तो group number 13 to 18 आपको there will be presence of non-metals. There are some metals also and some metallites also. So how can we define non-metals? On the basis of their properties, we can define them as they do not conduct electricity and they are neither malleable nor ductile. Non-metals are the element which form negative ion by gaining an electron. Thus, non-metals are also known as electronegative elements. So this is an important definition which is totally based on the chemistry. That means it's just opposite to the metals. Jaise metal mein kya hota hai, they have a tendency to lose electron, but what happens in case of non-metals? Non-metals have a tendency to gain electron, and by gaining electron they form negative ions. So here we can see, yes, suppose oxygen have a tendency to gain electron, and by gaining electron it form negative ion. Similarly, chlorine have a tendency to accept one electron and form chloride ion, right? Fluorine also have a tendency to form fluoride ion. So this is the main property of non-metal, that they have a tendency to form negative ions by gaining electrons. That's why they are known as electronegative element. Okay, so next one is, in this chapter we will learn which elements are non-metals and the criteria for placing them in this criteria. Means what are the properties on the basis of we are calling them non-metals. Means hum us un properties pe focus karne wale hain, basically ki what are the criteria for the non-metals ki aap usko non-metal bol sake. Secondly, we will also study in details three non-metals, hydrogen, oxygen and nitrogen, which are important for sustaining life on earth. So in this chapter, एक generalized information about the all non-metals and specific study about hydrogen, oxygen and nitrogen will be there. Physical properties of non-metals. So what are the physical properties of non-metal? Here we are listing. First of all, non-metals may be solid, liquid or gas at room temperature, right? For example, bromine is liquid at room temperature, carbon, sulfur, phosphorus are solid, whereas nitrogen, hydrogen, chlorine, fluorine, etc. are gases. But what we will study about the metals, metal ke case mein kya hota hai? They all are generally solid, only mercury is exception and gallium with low melting point. About baki jo all other elements hai, they are solid at room temperature. So here non-metals may be solid, liquid or gas. Most non-metals which are solid are brittle in nature. So here a word brittle comes. Brittle means ye hota hai ki ये इनके जो क्रिस्टल होंगे एक्चुअली दे आर नॉन क्रिस्टलाइन इन नेचर, उनकी कोई ज्योमेट्री फिक्स नहीं होती. एंड बाय अप्लाइंग अ वेरी स्मॉल अमाउंट ऑफ फोर्स वी कैन ब्रेक देम. आप बहुत ईजिली उसको क्या कर सकते हो, ब्रेक कर सकते हो. सो दैट इज़ कॉल्ड ब्रिटल इन नेचर. नॉन मेटल्स डू नॉट डिस्प्ले डक्टिलिटी, दे आर नॉट डक्टाइल एक्चुअली, मेलिएबिलिटी, नॉर दे डू प्रोड्यूस अ मेटेलिक साउंड. सो दीज ऑल आर द प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ मेटल्स. डक्टाइल, वॉट डू यू मीन बाई डक्टाइल, मीन्स दे कैन बी ड्रॉन इन टू अ वायर. वॉट डू यू मीन बाई मेलिएबिलिटी, मीन्स दे कैन बी प्रिपेयर इन टू अ थिन शीट बाई बिटन अप. एंड मेटेलिक साउंड मीन्स दे आर सोनोरस इन नेचर. सो दीज ऑल प्रॉपर्टीज आर नॉट शोन बाई नॉन मेटल्स एक्सेप्ट सम एक्सेप्शंस. ऑल अदर नॉन मेटल्स आर पुअर इलेक्ट्रिक कंडक्टर और इंसुलेटर. हियर एक्सेप्शन इज देयर ग्रेफाइट विच इज़ एन एलोट्रोप ऑफ कार्बन. ऑफ कार्बन इज अ कंडक्टर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिसिटी. मीन्स जनरली दे आर नॉन कंडक्टर और एक्ट एज इंसुलेटर और समटाइम्स दे आर वेरी पुअर कंडक्टर. बट ग्रेफाइट इज अ कंडक्टर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिसिटी. हियर अ वर्ड एलोट्रोपी, सो वी विल डिस्कस लेटर ऑन. सिमिलरली एक्सेप्ट डायमंड ऑल अदर नॉन मेटल्स आर पुअर थर्मल कंडक्टर्स. हियर we will discuss allotropy. Allotropy or allotropism is the property of some chemical elements to exist in two or more different forms in the same physical state known as allotropes of the element. Allotropes are different structural modification of an element. The atoms of the element are bonded together in different manner. So I'll explain here. Here you can see this is diamond, right? And this is graphite. Both are made up of carbon, right? But their structures are different. Here you can see it is three-dimensionally tetrahedrally structured and it is in the layered form, hexagonal layered form. So due to their arrangement, their physical property is totally changed. Both are solid state, both are solid at room temperature, but their physical appearance is totally different. Their physical properties are totally different, but chemically both are carbon. That means hum allotropes kisko bolenge. Allotropes mein jo unka element hoga, means jin atom se wo milke bane hain, both will be same. This is an example. There are more other examples of different element. और भी elements हैं जो allotropism show करते हैं, like oxygen. Oxygen is also present in two forms, ozone and simply oxygen, O2 and O3. Both are the allotropes of each other. दोनों की property अलग अलग होती है. Okay, so allotropism, I think allotropism आप लोगों को समझ में आ गया होगा कि allotropism is the property of some chemical element to exist in two or more different form. Means they have a same physical state, they have a same chemical property, but their appearance is totally different. So this phenomenon is known as allotropism. Okay, graphite and diamond both are solely made up of carbon atoms, but their physical appearance is very different. Since the atoms of different allotropes of an element are identical, therefore the chemical reaction shown by them are same. Because they are made up of the same element, that's why their chemical reactions will be similar. For example, both graphite and diamond give carbon dioxide on combustion. Whenever you are going for combustion of graphite and diamond, ultimately you'll get carbon dioxide. Why? Because both are made up of carbon only. Oxygen, phosphorus, sulfur are the some other non-metals that exhibit allotropy. So here the position of non-metal, right? यहाँ पर आप लोग देख पा रहे होंगे देयर इज़ अ पीरियोडिक टेबल. हियर ये जो ब्लू कलर में आपको जितने भी एलिमेंट दिखाई दे रहे हैं दे ऑल आर मेटल्स एंड द येलो वन आर नॉन मेटल्स एंड दिस पिंक वन आर मेटलॉइड्स. सो दिस इज़ द पोजीशन ऑफ नॉन मेटल्स इन द पीरियोडिक टेबल. यू कैन सी एक्सेप्ट हाइड्रोजन. हाइड्रोजन को अगर आप छोड़ दो तो ऑल नॉन मेटल बिलोंग्स टू द पी ब्लॉक. हियर यू कैन सी देयर इज ओनली वन मेंबर फ्रॉम ग्रुप नंबर 14. ग्रुप नंबर, दिस इज द ग्रुप नंबर 14 कार्बन. ग्रुप नंबर 15 There are two member, nitrogen and phosphorus. Group number 16, oxygen, sulfur and selenium. Group number 17, fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine and astatine. And group number 18, all members are non-metals, right? But these are the metalloids. So what are the metalloids? Actually, they show some properties like metals, some properties like non-metals. So this is a transition state, means the elements are converting from metal to non-metal. As we know, whenever we move from left to right, jab bhi hum periodic table ke period mein left to right move karte hain, then there is a decrease in metallic property. These are the strong metals, na? These are the typical metals. Jaise aap move on karoge from left to right, then metallic property will decrease and ultimately they are converting into the non-metal. Each and every period is ended with non-metals, right? So here it is the transition state. Yahan par ye metal se non-metal mein convert ho raha hai, right? Okay, so there are some properties that exhibited only by metal, while there are other properties that are shown only by non-metal. So this is the distinction, na? Means that is totally different. Some properties are totally different, which are shown only by metals, and some are shown only by non-metal. Some elements that show some properties of metals and other non-metals, that is their properties lie somewhere in the middle. So this is the transition period jo main aap logon ko bata rahi thi. They are known as metalloid. In the periodic table, these elements are located between metal and non-metal. That's why we don't see a sudden change in metallic group as we move from one group to the next group. So that changes stepwise. Abhi aap log jo periodic table dekh rahe the, yahan par aap dekh sakte ho, this is like a steps. Ye dekhi, stepwise. Okay. In the periodic, the behavior is sand in elements situated along a zigzag diagonal line in the periodic table. The behavior is said, okay, in the elements situated along the zigzag diagonal line in the periodic table. These elements are counted among the metals but are called metalloid or semi-metal. Metalloid include boron, silicon, germanium, arsenic, antimony, aluminium, polonium, etc. So these are the metalloids and they show the properties, some from the metal and some from the non-metal. Boron, silicon, germanium are poor conductor of electricity, but addition of impurities leads to the electrical conductivity. They are known as semiconductor and they are very useful for the making of diodes and transistors, etc. ये इसमें आप क्या करते हैं, silicon, germanium, इसमें अगर हम if we are going to add some impurities of group 13 and 15, then their electrical conductivity will be altered, change हो जाती है. So according to requirement, we can change the conductivity of silicon and germanium. So they are used as a semiconductor. All elements that do not belong to the metals and non-metals are and metalloids are called non-metal. So those elements which are not belonging to the metals and metalloid group, they are known as non-metals. So how non-metals are discovered? So first of all, carbon and sulfur are the two non-metals that were known even in the ancient time. Means bahut पहले से हम कार्बन एंड सल्फर के बारे में जानते हैं. इनफैक्ट दे वर डिस्कवर्ड सो लॉन्ग एगो दैट वी डोंट नो द एग्जैक्ट डेट्स और नेम्स ऑफ द पर्सन हु डिस्कवर्ड देम, राइट? इन नेचर कार्बन इज फाउंड एज डायमंड एंड ग्रेफाइट एंड दीज टू फॉर्म्स हैव बीन मेंशनड इन द वेरियस एंशियंट डॉक्यूमेंट्स. But initially these two forms were regarded as two separate substances. जब हमको allotropism के बारे में पता नहीं था, then these two substances means diamond and graphite, both are considered as two separate substances. It was only the development of modern chemistry that we understood that diamond and graphite are actually carbon, which give carbon dioxide on burning. So जब modern chemistry developed हुई, then after that, after the study and lots of experiment, we get that कि graphite and carbon both are actually same. They just look different, but chemically both are same. Lavoisier carried out combustion of carbon and diamond and proved that both are actually element of carbon. Similarly, sulfur was also known from the ancient time, and again it was Lavoisier who proved that sulfur is an element. Phosphorus was discovered in the middle age at the 1669 by Hennig Brand. Till the middle ages, very little was known about the gaseous substances. Since most non-metals are found as gases in the nature, therefore they were discovered only after techniques to produce and collect gases had been refined. So as we know, generally non-metals are gaseous in nature, so their discovery was little bit late because we don't have the proper techniques to collect and produce the gases. So after the discovery of the techniques, we just studied about the non-metals that are gases. So fluorine and chlorine was discovered by Swedish chemist Scheele. Inert gases are found in the free state in nature, but only interest amount, therefore their discovery was also took some time. Actually they are inert in nature and they are present only in very very little amounts. Okay, so that's why they are, so here there is a correction, this is not interest, this is the trace amount. Now I can write here, it's not interest, it is trace, it's printing mistake, only trace amounts. Therefore their discovery also took some time because they are inert, they have shown zero oxidation number, they don't form any kind of compounds, that's why their discovery was little bit late. Actually ye jo inert gas hai ye bahut pehle discover ho chuki thi, but iska jo recognition hai, identification hai, इसको होने में बहुत टाइम लग गया बिकॉज इट्स नॉट गोइंग टू फॉर्म एनी काइंड ऑफ कंपाउंड्स, इट्स नॉट गोइंग टू शो एनी काइंड ऑफ रिएक्टिविटी, दैट्स वाई देयर डिस्कवरी वॉज लेट. सो रैमसे सेपरेटेड द गैसेस आर्गन, इट्स नॉट ऑर्गन, इट्स आर्गन, हीलियम, ओके, इट्स आर्गन, हीलियम, नियॉन, क्रिप्टॉन एंड ज़ीनॉन. In this way, most of the non-metals had been discovered by the end of 19th century. So the last topic, that is chemical properties of non-metal. Non-metals are found between group 14 to 18 in the periodic table. Non-metals have 4 to 8 electrons in their outermost orbit and they have a tendency to gain electron. Therefore, they are electronegative in nature. The electronegativity of each non-metal is not the same and the value of electronegativity of non-metal ranges from 2.01 to 4.1. Fluorine has the highest electronegativity value and that for oxygen and chlorine is also quite close. Oxygen and chlorine actually have the similar electronegativity and fluorine is the most electronegative element. All the non-metal except those in group 18 form negative ion and covalent bonds during the chemical reaction. Generally, non-metals have a tendency to form covalent bonds. So first, a reaction, that is reaction between metal and non-metal. Metals and non-metals react with one another to form anionic compound where metal is oxidized and non-metal is reduced. So here we can see magnesium is reacting with oxygen forming magnesium oxide, copper, oxygen, copper oxide, iron and sulfur, iron sulfide. Magnesium and nitrogen, magnesium nitride, nitrogen and chlorine, sodium chloride and calcium phosphorus, calcium phosphate. As we know, metals are electropositive and non-metals are electronegative. So here all the compounds are generally ionic in nature. The second one is reaction between non-metal. Covalent bonds are formed when non-metal react with one another because non-metals, in case of non-metals, both are same as in their electronegativity, that's the bonds are covalent. These are the example where carbon and chlorine are going to react with each other. There is a formation of carbon tetrachloride. Here hydrogen chloride, phosphorus trichloride, carbon dioxide, sulfur dioxide and phosphorus pentoxide. So these are the examples of non-metals reacting together and forming covalent compounds. The next one is nature of oxide of the non-metal. Generally, the solution of oxides are acidic in nature, non-metal oxides, right? But all the non-metal oxides are not acidic. We know that the water is an oxide of hydrogen, but it's neutral. In simple other words, we can understand that it generally all the oxides of non-metals are acidic in nature. Generally, we expect ki inke oxide kaise hone chahiye, acidic hone chahiye. But it's not necessary that all the oxides of the non-metals will be acidic. Some of them are amphoteric. Amphoteric means neutral. With strong acid, they behave as base, and with strong base, they behave as acid. So that is called amphoteric nature. So only some of them are amphoteric nature, but generally they are acidic in nature. So this is all about the topics. So thank you. Keep watching, like, share and subscribe the channel. Thank you.